via decision. Now let's get into Robert Hellenius versus Adam Konacki 2. Robert Hellenius, 30 wins and 3 losses versus Adam Konacki, 20 wins and 1 loss. That one loss is obviously to Robert Hellenius in his very last fight, in a fight that Adam Konacki was a huge, huge favorite. Look at the money that you could have gotten if you went with Robert Hellenius. Now, I did have concerns about Adam Konacki going into this fight because of how much he got punched versus Chris Areola in his previous fight, where they set like a heavyweight record for punches landed in a 12-rounder. Like, you know, Adam Konacki was just knocking on the door of the ring-recognized top 10 in the heavyweight division. He was just outside of, like, the Joseph Parkers and the Andy Ruizes. He was just outside of that because he was beating slightly better and better competition. It was no longer like the Arthur Spielkas like he did in 2017 when he knocked Spielka out in the 4th round. He beat Charles Martin via decision. Charles Martin somehow, you know, ended up with a championship belt and ended up getting knocked out by Anthony Joshua. And that was actually Anthony Joshua's first title. It was versus Charles Martin. But Adam Konacki decision won over Charles Martin. And then he knocked out Gerald Washington. And Gerald Washington has actually knocked out Robert Hellenius. So going into Konacki versus Hellenius 1, Hellenius was like 36 or something years old, and he was kind of like the journeyman by this point. Now, granted, he's only lost 3 fights. He's beaten, you know, he's got a decision win over Derek Chisora in a fight that he won by decision, but most people who are watching the fight thought that Derek Chisora kind of got jobbed in that one. It was a split decision win for Hellenius. But man, you've seen Chisora now get the unfavorable end of the stick in decisions versus Hellenius. Versus Joseph Parker versus Oleksandr Usyk. Like, he's always or often in the fight. And he's like, he fought a very competitive fight with an old Vitaly Klitschko. I mean, no, people weren't just beating Vitaly Klitschko, and Derek Chisora fought a very spirited fight versus him. So that one really got my attention. I'm like, damn, okay, note to self, take Chisora seriously. And he's just had a spirited career. But Hellenius got the decision win over him, and he's also, you know, been in there with and went the distance with Dillian White. So Hellenius has fought some of the top fighters, and I mean, when he's winning and knocking the guys out, he looks like a tower. It's like, man, this guy looks like he could be like one of the elite fighters, but then he'll, you know, get knocked out by Duhapis. That was the one that really kind of set his career back because he was collecting like these European titles as early as like 10 years ago. So like in 2010, he was fighting for these like regional titles, and Hellenius really didn't have his first setback until like 2016. Like he went into that fight 22-0, and he was again collecting regional titles 5 years prior, but he got knocked out in the 6th round by Johan Duhapis, and that was like a pretty big setback. He won his next few, and then he lost via decision to Dillian White. So he's been one of these guys who will beat most guys, but then when he'll, you know, that's not even when he has a huge step up in class, but he'll just lose when he's got all the momentum going in. So every time he like scales the mountain, he just gets knocked off again. But given his experience and his ability to finish fighters, there was concern when Adam Konacki was going into the ring against Robert Hellenius. Because as he was kind of being billed, while Hellenius was kind of having this like journeyman style career, Konacki was like being put higher and higher on some undercards, and then started having his own fight nights, like this one against Areola, that ended up being way more of a slugfest than you would have thought it should have been, because Konacki was not only climbing up the rankings and getting increased attention from PBC, because he's a Polish New Yorker. There was a big fan base that was building and building for Konacki, but he's kind of like a patient hunter. Like, he's not a footwork guy. He's got slow feet, like Andy Ruiz has slow feet. But he's somebody who likes to let their hands go. So what he does is he starts like kind of dipping, fainting, just like some trunk movement. Something that Efe Ajagba doesn't show a ton of. You know, I was just talking to Ajagba. Sanchez doesn't show a ton of trunk movement. Sanchez does. You know, Konacki does have a little bit of these little nuanced things that'll get the guy to like open up. So then you throw, you know, a couple punches. And what you're trying to do ultimately is kind of get the guy to start backing up into the ropes so you can sort of corner and trap him and then let some power punches go. That's what Konacki likes to do. But against Areola, unlike the fight, you know, unlike when Konacki fought Gerald Washington or Charles Martin, Areola made him pay consistently. Like I said, there was a record set in that fight for punches landed. Just continuously made Konashki pay for getting reckless in his, in where he keeps his hands, where he, if he's keeping his head on the center line. Oh, Konashki was not doing enough movement. And that's kind of what separates a lot of these guys who have long, sustainable careers versus the ones who start looking kind of hot and then get their chin checked and destroyed a couple times to where they're never really the same fighter. And then they end up just being the B-side to like other guys as like step-up fights going forward. When I saw Konashki versus Areola, even though Konashki won the fight via unanimous decision, I was thinking, how sustainable is this approach? But I didn't think that Hellenius would be the guy to make him pay, ultimately, and to deliver him his first loss. But that's exactly what Hellenius did. He knocked him out in the fourth round. Konashki got hurt badly in the third round, and then got finished in the fourth. Because again, Hellenius is a super tall fighter. We're talking 6'7 versus 6'3 Adam Konashki. So think about it. Anthony Joshua was 6'6 to Andy Ruiz's 6'3. 3-inch height advantage for AJ. Hellenius versus Konashki, 4-inch height advantage. So if you don't get out of the way and account for Hellenius's straight right hand, like, you will suffer. And that's exactly what Konashki did. So I think coming into this rematch, he's got his game face on. He knows, I can't let this guy drill me like that. So I think that he's going to have to show more head movement, and I think that he's going to have to hurt Hellenius, or at least do something to discourage Hellenius from letting his hands go freely. So will Konashki, the babyface, be able to make the adjustments needed to rectify the result versus Hellenius? You know, I think he will. I think he's going to be very serious and a little bit more mindful on his defense. But I think that he'll actually be able to, if not drop, hurt Hellenius at a certain point to where Hellenius finds himself looking for opportunities to land the big punch, but is getting boxed kind of moment by moment. Look, Hellenius did flash a nice jab, and there's a reason why he was able to set him up with the right hand. It's because he was getting pretty busy with his left jab, being able to punch downward at Konashki, who was eating jabs before he ate the right. But I think Konashki is going to be able to pin Hellenius enough where he kind of takes control of this one. And because if he lets Hellenius stick around to the 8th, 9th, and 10th, that Hellenius will still be dangerous and can pull off a late knockout of Konashki. I think Konashki's actually, it's tough. Will Konashki finish him in the early to mid rounds? I don't think that's necessarily going to happen. But does Hellenius have enough fuel to keep on making Konashki pay during some of the slow moments or some of the moments where Konashki is recklessly entering the pocket? Maybe. I just feel like the most likely scenario is that the first couple rounds take on a slower pace than in the first fight, because these guys came in guns blazing first couple rounds in this first fight. I think it's going to be a slower start to this next fight, and I think that Konashki is going to start doing some of the more nuanced things that got him success in his earlier fights before suffering this knockout. And I think that he's gonna be able to trap Hellenius a few times. It's just hard for me to picture how he's gonna be able to win a decision without at some point getting hurt by Hellenius. Like, if Hellenius is sticking around and is gonna be the taller fighter who doesn't have to do as much to close the range because it's a 79-inch reach versus a 76-inch reach, you know, I kind of think that why do I feel compelled to pick Konashki if all signs are kind of pointing to a repeat of the first fight? I don't know. I just think that there is something that was elite or near elite in Konashki, and I think that he's good enough to make enough defensive adjustments to where he doesn't get drilled and caught the way that he did in the first fight. Now, but does he get Hellenius out of there? I mean, Hellenius, again, went the distance versus Dillian White. You know, I'm actually going to pick Konashki versus not a lackluster decision, but something that's less than explosive. I think Konashki's actually going to win the decision here. And that is pretty much a testament to Hellenius's experience. Like, okay, no, I wasn't able to deck him with the right hand, but I still had enough goods and enough smarts to be able to keep him from finishing me against the ropes. So I'm going to actually go with Adam Konashki via decision. But yeah, let me know what you think about both of these co-main, and then we'll call it the third fight down on the Fury versus Wilder 3 undercard. Again, I'm just ecstatic that we have a fight card that's actually resembling one of the UFC pay-per-view fight cards where it's 3, 4, 5, sometimes 5 good fights deep. But yeah, let me know what you think about Efe Ajagba versus Frank Sanchez and Robert Hellenius versus Adam Konashki too. Please leave your comments in the comments, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you are into the fight talk. I'm Woog. Thanks for tuning in.